For many of us, working remotely involves time spent working alone, combined with asynchronous interactions with our colleagues and associates. Sometimes, though, you really need to get together to talk things through or make decisions. Meetings are important, not only for getting things done, but also for maintaining your relationships and nurturing personal connections too.
The thing about meetings in general is they can be more or less effective. Virtual meetings are especially tricky due to the added challenges that come with complicated technology, a poor internet connection, or simply the fact we miss out on perceiving body language and nonverbal cues, which in turn can make communication more difficult. In fact, meetings can sometimes be downright draining or frustrating, and you might even find yourself wishing you'd never joined a meeting at all. Hi, I'm James.
And I'm Lili. We are co-developers of Sociocracy 3.0, and in this video we're going to look at S3 patterns that can help you get the best out of your virtual meetings. We'll explore how you can spend your time with colleagues effectively and stay focused on what really matters, so that you can create value together and enjoy having a good time doing so too.
You can radically enhance the success of your online meetings by putting a few key things in place. Firstly, use reliable digital tools and choose some dedicated people to take responsibility for key roles to help your meetings run effectively. Define expectations among attendees and invite people to participate artfully during the meeting. Encourage everyone to prepare well in advance and define some agreed-on rules of the game so that people know what to expect and what's expected of them.
In this video, we'll cover all this and more. We'll share a number of practical tips and tricks and introduce you to practices that will support you and your colleagues to really get the best out of your online meetings. It may be that you're already familiar with some of the content of this video, so do feel free to check out the timestamps in the description below and jump straight to the sections that are relevant to you.
Digital tools are essential for virtual meetings, not only for running the meeting itself, but also for enabling ongoing communication and keeping track of information before, during, and after your meeting. For a start, you'll need a virtual meeting space, and ideally one where you can see as well as hear each other. While an audio-only option may mean that you can wear your pajamas, it is worth considering the advantages of a tool that enables you to actually see each other too. Being able to read body language and facial cues can greatly enhance your communication. There are many video conferencing solutions to choose from, with a variety of features. We prefer a tool with breakout rooms, so you can easily divide tasks up in the meeting sometimes, rather than doing everything together all of the time. There are many great options to choose from, for example, GoToMeeting, Google Hangouts, BlueJeans, or Jitsi.org, and it's worth taking the time to research which tool will best meet your needs. By the way, make sure you have a reliable internet connection, especially if you're the one hosting the call. Otherwise, all of this is going to be pretty useless. Some video conference solutions also include inbuilt messaging apps like Microsoft Teams or Google Hangouts Chat, for example. But with many solutions, messaging is only available during the call itself. In this case, you're going to benefit from using a separate tool for messaging and notifications so that you can communicate easily before and after the call as well.
If you're working and meeting together on a regular basis, you're also going to need a data management system to record and keep track of relevant information for your team, as well as for the whole organization. In S3, we call this system a logbook. A logbook is basically the organization's memory, where you store all the information required to ensure collaboration runs smoothly. Common platforms for logbooks include wikis like DokuWiki, MediaWiki, Confluence, or content management systems like G Suite, Evernote, or Trello. Larger organizations tend to use a combination of tools to manage their data, and there's really no perfect solution, so you're gonna have to figure out what works best for you. To keep a logbook in order and up to date, it can help to have a person dedicated to the task. We call this role a logbook keeper, and their main responsibility is to ensure that agreements and other relevant data are stored in a coherent manner so that the team members can find the information easily and understand it when they need it.
How about note-taking during the meeting, though? It's inevitably going to be distracting for whoever does it. and it may be that someone other than the logbook keeper is better able to fulfill the task. Ask for 2 volunteers, a competent typist and someone in reserve to follow along, correct typos, and take over in a moment when your note taker is engaged in the content itself. Alternatively, invite several attendees to contribute in a collaborative document.
It's also worth mentioning the value of using collaborative writing and visualization tools. For document writing, we use Google Docs to visualize meeting notes and capture details about the agreements we make. For interactive whiteboards and working with stickies, Mural or Miro provides feature-rich options, although Google Jamboard will probably be enough if you just want to play around with a few stickies. To wrap up this section on tools, consider finding a way to visualize time for everyone in the meeting. Use 2 timers, one to keep track of how long you have left for a particular agenda item, and another to visualize how much time is remaining overall. This, and regularly reminding people to adjust the length of their contributions accordingly, really helps keep things on track. If you're looking for on-screen timers, you can check out DuckDuckGo or Windows timers.
So, next up, let's look at some key roles that will help you get the best out of your meeting. We've already mentioned the value of having a logbook keeper to help sort out and store relevant information. But what about other roles? For example, who will take responsibility for preparing and setting up the meeting or following up with attendees afterwards? We call this role a meeting host, someone who prepares and distributes the agenda, identifies and invites participants, and hosts your call on a platform of choice. Sometimes you might choose someone to be a meeting host for a single call, or if your meetings are ongoing, consider choosing one of the team to take on this role for a period of time.
The responsibilities of a meeting host are often confused with another important role, the meeting facilitator. Although these 2 roles are sometimes fulfilled by the same person, they're quite different. A facilitator's main task is to support the flow of the meeting itself and help attendees to contribute with their unique wisdom, experience, and skills. Choosing someone to guide your meeting will help everyone maintain focus and keep the meeting on track. Of course, good facilitation improves meeting effectiveness a lot, but most important of all, perhaps, attendees need to participate artfully themselves. Artful participation involves checking regularly to see whether your behaviour in a given moment is the best contribution you can make to the effectiveness of the meeting. Explicitly inviting artful participation at the start of a meeting, and maybe even suggesting a pause for reflection from time to time throughout a call, can really enhance people's ability to stay conscious of how they're contributing and identify when to make adjustments as the call proceeds.
You want to use your precious scheduled meeting time to best effect. In whatever ways you can, prepare for your meetings ahead of time. Basically, anything that doesn't require a face-to-face or at least voice-to-voice interaction can be done beforehand. This way, you'll be able to focus on what really matters when you get together and stay engaged throughout the meeting. By the way, this also includes scheduling the next meeting dates outside of the meeting time. Let's take a closer look at what you can do to prepare.
Think about who to invite and who not to invite to the meeting. Just because you work with certain people on a daily basis, it doesn't mean that everyone needs to attend every meeting. There may also be people you wouldn't normally invite, but who can add value by bringing another perspective or certain expertise. Create an agenda for the meeting. In the case of a team that meets regularly, we recommend using some kind of Kanban board to visualize your work. That's a column-based interface for tracking the status of tasks. We often use Trello for this. Here's how it works. Prioritize your backlog and pull items from the top into your agenda. Prioritize the items in your agenda too, so that you deal with the most important things first. Then, if you run over time on something during the meeting, it'll be the least important topics that fall off the end.
When it comes to items in your agenda, depending on the type of meeting, you're going to have a list of things you need to do together, such as actions or activities, or a list of things that require decisions to be made. Sometimes you'll have a combination of both. In this case, consider dedicating part of the meeting for working on actionable items and the other part for decision-making. And if you're meeting to make agreements together, be sure to describe clearly for each item the organizational need you're aiming to respond to so that the why is clear before you begin. Consider describing the outcomes you'd like to be achieved for each item. Try to be specific. Detail any process you think would be helpful to use and explain in the card what people need to do to prepare. There may be documents to read, conversations to have, or questions to be asked and answered. In any case, be explicit so people know what's expected of them. And if you're adding an item to a meeting agenda, include an estimate of how much time you think would be appropriate to spend on it. Note, I didn't say how much time it will take to complete the item, but how much time you want to spend on it. We often underestimate how long things will take, but we usually know how much time we have for a meeting. In Trello, you can use the custom fields power-up to add a time estimation to each card. So, when it comes to putting an agenda together, you'll already have some idea of the overall time requested for each item and can set a realistic meeting duration, or include the realistic number of items in the agenda.
If you're preparing for someone else's agenda item, be sure to act on any prerequisites and check the whole agenda for any potential problems concerning content or order, and let relevant people know if you see ways it might be improved. Last but not least, if you're meeting regularly, remember to review any records of the last meeting's evaluation before showing up for the meeting, and consider how you might act on improvement suggestions this time. With all this in place, you'll have removed a lot of potential for waste and increased the chances of enjoying a co-creative time together.